Hey, it's me, GV, and welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. This is part 61. In the last episode, we entered Redwater Den, where we found out that the Skooma dealers, I think it was obviously a front, but I'm not sure right now whether the Skooma dealers were working with the vampire. Yeah, that must have been how it was, right? The Skooma dealers were working with the vampires, probably their thralls. I mean, that's just how vampires operate. And really, the vampires were taking people that passed out from the Redwater Skooma and using them as thralls or sucking their blood or doing other vampire-y things. So not only are we stopping this ill practice that I'm sure Harkon does not validate or... Hey, Harkon, you validate Parkin?
Yes, just go in the back. We validate. That's my
Harkon vampire accent, but that's not how he talks. That's stereotypical vampire, and Harkon's a more respected vampire. Anyways, we're all over the place here. We're going to go into the Redwater Spring now. I seem to remember this location being big, but it might just be a mistaken memory considering this location is really fleshed out, and there's lots of weird, interesting... interactions with all of the different stuff. For instance, the last time I was here in Skyrim's Hidden Treasures, I just ran through and killed everybody. I never realized that we could consume the Redwater Skooma and then be put in a cell, because that's pretty cool. Here we have Venaris Vulpin's journal. Vulpin is always used with vampires for some reason. I'm pretty sure it's the etymology ties with wolf, like Volpe, wolf, I don't know. I'm not exactly sure. Either way, you guys can pause the video on these pages if you would like to read this. Looks like it's pretty damn lengthy, and that is it. We're going to take it, though, considering it is unique. We're also going to take these three pieces of gold, which is probably not worth my time, but at the same time, I see gold and I take it. That's just what I do.
So why don't you drink the blood from the spring? I mean, that seems easier than running a Skooma den.
The boss said it's some sort of profaned spring. It looks like blood, but it's not the real thing. Drinking it gives you strength. But it also gets you pretty messed up. That's why we thought of putting it in the Skooma.
Okay, we've got a pretty big area on our hands, it looks like. Let's see what's on this table. We also have telekinesis, by the way. You know what? Let's try that out right now. Let's see how much telekinesis actually improves our acceleration and how fast. So we can waste all of our magicka just basically grabbing it and holding it. Which did increase it by one, so I'm not sure what the growth factor here is. I'm not sure if we just use it and drop it. Let's try that. And then we'll drop it. Okay, so that doesn't seem to increase it. Let's try it one more time. Okay, so I think it's just based on the amount of time you're holding the telekinesis down. So it is kind of... It does seem to be worse, though, than using Soul Trap on bodies and Muffle. This one seems to be a bit tougher because it drains our magicka so quickly. Let's see. Okay, yeah, so it's based on the time that you hold the book. All right, so we'll try that, and then we'll try Detect Life when we enter like somewhere like Whiterun, where there's a lot of people, and we'll see which one increases it better. Anyways, we have a gate here, and also let's go back to Conjure Jamora Lord. Put that away. We have a gate here, which doesn't look like we're going to get through. I'm going to remain and sneak. We also have a fire pot, where no doubt there's going to be some oil under it. Yep, that is the case. Okay, it looks like we can head down here. So down we go. Now, we will shoot that oil pot with a bound arrow. If there is somebody under it, it does not look like they are. Which is very unfortunate. Although, are they? Oh, you know what? It looks like they are standing. Okay, so we'll use bound bow, which should be completely silent thanks to our quiet casting perk. And we'll go ahead and shoot this one. And this one. And this one. And this one. Now, I wonder if these vampires have that weakness to fire inside of them already. We've got one more guy over here, it looks like. Great arrow by me, as usual. Okay. Nope. Sorry, I'm playing as a stealthy character, my friend. Okay, let's also kill these death hounds who are not happy to see me. And grab Conjure Jamora Lord again. Okay, skin. Didn't think that would activate immediately. I was gonna ask, can we drop down there? And the answer is a very clear yes. Okay. The Death Hounds never seem to have anything that we can loot whatsoever, but we can obviously loot these guys. Redwater Den backroom scheme. Pretty sure we already have one. Let's break sneak and drag these bodies into the pit? Okay, that was weird. It looked like he was just gonna fly up. Okay, we've got a Nord here. We'll drag... What is going on? Yeah, they're just floating up immediately after I hold the A button on the controller. Oh, some people don't realize, so I think I have to say a couple times. This is on PC. We are playing on PC. Even though I am playing with an Xbox 360 controller, so obviously it's giving me all of the button prompts. But yes, this is on PC. You don't get this FPS, guys. You don't get this FPS on consoles. Just, well, on 360 at least. Okay, so we can go down. I think that's our only option. We could also drop down into the pit, but there's probably spikes down there. I'm forgetting. But I don't know about you guys. I don't really like spikes up my ass too much. Only on the weekends, you know? Okay, we'll take that. This is a trap chest, so we'll activate it, and then we will immediately jump back. You're not getting me here. Oh! Oh! Okay. That was a close call. Ah! Damn it. Okay, these don't even do any damage to me anymore. Okay, there are spikes. I hate how these work because, like, if you just walk around them, they shouldn't be, like, hurting you. But if we, like, touch them... Oh, my... And the dumbest death of the entire Let's Play goes to that one right there. And oh god. Oh god. Okay, this isn't too far back. I'll meet you guys back where I just... Jesus Christ. Alright guys, welcome back. That weird, terrible, horrible, stupid death never happened. You guys imagined that. I know it's sometimes your mind just creates memories where they didn't happen. You know, it's really, really, really weird. But that was you. You guys are crazy. I'm totally good at this game. Absolutely. We're gonna go over here now, and we're gonna grab this chest using Whirlwind Sprint because, like I said, I'm super good at this game. I recognized this chest was over here. And then I use Whirlwind Sprint to get over there because my mind just is amazing, works in wonderful ways, and has told me, you know, Vanna, everything came together immediately and just let me know what I needed to do to grab that chest. So there we go. I'm God at this game and we're moving on. I definitely did not die in a terrible way. You guys are mistaken. Again, I'm only going to say it one more time. Stop bringing it up. Yeah, that death did not happen. So let's move on. We've got Thorn behind us and we will... go up. Yeah, there's nothing down there but that little spike pit if you get caught. This looks like a trap chest, but you know what? It's not. It's not, and I knew it wasn't because I didn't see a little tiny... By the way, to distinguish, there's always a little tiny rope coming off of the side there. But usually the trap chests are placed in places like this. Anyways, we've got a gate in front of us, which is probably the gate... Don't make me conjure you somewhere else just so I can move past you, dude. That is not cool. Okay, there we go. So that's going to open that, and no doubt this one as well. And then we can continue forth in this direction. Did I miss something? Oh, yeah, that's right. We died, so I didn't grab this journal. I mean, we didn't die. I guess this was a bug. The journal appeared again. Weird. Come on, Bethesda. Come on. Get on your bugs. Stop making them so prevalent. You guys know what I mean? Anyways, this is a Draugr area. I wonder if we'll find Draugr, or I wonder if we'll find that the vampires have cleared them all out. That's got to be what it is, right? Okay, we've got a guy in the distance here. Let's summon Thorn right behind him and see everybody that's going to come out of the woodwork. In the meantime, we will grab Bound Bow and use that. Conjuration is 95. Wonderful. Could just grind out the rest using Soul Trap on a body. But for now, we will help Thorn by firing arrows from afar. Easy peasy. We've got at least one more enemy here. What is it, Thorn? I knew it was going to be a Death Hound. It's all yours, man. It's all yours. There you go. Yes! Oh, God, you're awesome. I agree, dude. I agree with everything that you see. You just make so much sense, man. You know that? Yeah, so the Garnet is the only thing of any worth or note that we found on Death Hounds so far. We have a Master Vampire here who died pretty fast. Who died pretty swiftly, surprisingly enough. We have a Vampire... And then we have another coffin. You cannot sleep when enemies are nearby. Well, that's unfortunate because it looks like we get a little bonus when we sleep in a coffin, which is cool. I don't know if I've ever known that, but I definitely did not remember that. But it's really cool that if you sleep in a coffin, you get a bonus to your illusion. I wonder if it changes at all or if that's the only one. I mean, vampires would use illusion. That would be the school of magicka, right? That they'd be most adherent to. So that makes sense. Where is the enemy? I want to sleep in this damn coffin, but it's not letting me. Alright, well, Thorn, let's go. I think we only have one way open to us, and that is this way. No enemies in here either. Huh, and it's not letting me wait. Okay, let's open the wooden door. Oh! God, imagine seeing that in real life. And in real life, you die, too. Especially if you're just standing, like, right here. And they actually hit me. But that'd be scary as hell. God. I didn't play that in VR, you know? Okay, let's move on. Let's see. That change is going to activate. Wait, is it going to activate? It's got to be this door, right? Yeah. There's always two, usually. Okay, do we have anything of worth on this weird table with stuff? Does not look like it. Okay, we've got an iron door to the right. We've got a wooden door over here, which is going to have a potion of cure disease and a skeleton. And it looks like that is about it. We could make some potions, but we're not in potion-making mood. I'm not in a potion-making mood at the moment. Okay, we've got a trap to the left, trap to the right, trap in front of us. Which Thorn is no doubt. Oh god, Thorn. Okay, I saw the spike things up there, then I saw them to the right or to the left, and I was like, well, these are gonna hit me now. Okay, let's get as close to the door as possible. Looks like he dodged that one a little bit. I wonder if there's any AI whatsoever that tells this guy not to step on those. Okay, we've got a huge chamber here, which no doubt means we're gonna have a boss battle on our hands, and it looks like they recognize Thorn. So let's. What just happened? Oh, I had Thorn in one hand and... Okay. Yeah, we're going to wait a little bit to resummon him, especially to increase our conjuration. And then we're going to summon him over there, where we have Venaris Vulpin, the guy that wrote the journal. Okay, and now we're going to grab Bound Bow. Just hold off, buddy. I'll be right there with you. All right, let's take out the weak guys first. I just realized it's good that we're using... Thorn against these vampires, because they have to have some level of fire weakness, I would imagine. And Thorn's sword is obviously using fire.
And now you die.
And now you die. Sorry. And then one more for good measure. Totally meant to do that. Wasn't a slip of the trigger finger. Okay, you have some gold, some vampire dust, major destruction. Okay, let's take that. Pretty sure we found all this stuff by now, but, you know, never hurts to be sure. Here we have the unique Venaris Vulpin, who has some gold, Redwater Wellspring Key, and some Vampire Dust. Also, let's use this chance to heal ourselves. Okay, go back to Conjure Dremora Lord, put that away. Here we have a Vampire's Thrall, which again is not an actual vampire, just somebody that they are controlling. We will sleep for 1 hour. We could also sleep for 20. You know what? Let's do that and see what our next vampire power is going to be. I'm pretty sure it's every day. It seems to be every day, but it might be compounding, you know, like 1 day, 3 days, 7 days, or something like that. I don't really know. I've never played as a vampire. I only got the Vampire Lord to get the achievement, because I think there was an achievement for maxing out the perk tree. And that was the only experience I've ever had with playing as a vampire. Okay, you waken feeling a surge of vampiric power. Your vampiric powers grow as you hunger. Okay, so let's go into active effects. Now we have a 40% increase by 10% weakness to fire. But let's go to the top and see if we still have, yeah, Champion of the Night, and it's still illusion. And we could look down here, but I think that's going to be it. Let's go into powers, where surely enough we should have another one. Or not. Did it tell us that we got Vampire Seduction the last time? And it unfavorited Highborn again. Why is it doing that? I don't know. But yeah, it actually looks like we don't have new powers. Maybe our normal vampire. Maybe these are stronger. I am not sure. But regardless, let's loot this person. Even though we already did, but I knew that. I just wanted to make sure, you know? Okay, here we have Venaris Vulpin's research. You guys can pause the screen if you'd like to read these. 1, 2, 3. I remember seeing this in the Skyrim's Hidden Treasures episode, and I was like, oh my god, there's a totally unrelated quest location. Totally unquest related locate, put those words in whatever way you see fit, with a journal, with a drawing, and, as you know, and everything else. This is amazing. Little did I realize this was actually quest related, just not for me personally. Elven Gilded Armor of Regeneration, we will take that. We've already slept in the coffin. Okay, let's just fully explore this location. We're almost done here. What is this? The goblet. Oh, yeah, that's right. The last time I came here, I didn't even have the chalice because we were not doing the vampire's quest. So this will be interesting, too, because I have not seen what you actually need to do. And if there are any animations involved. Here we have an orc. with a lockpick. And finally, we have an arcane enchanter. But before we mess with that, we also have a big chest over here with not... Oh, okay. All right, now let's see if we can disenchant any of that stuff. I don't think that's going to be the case. And indeed, it is not. So, how many soul gems do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4. We're just going to keep stockpiling them. We don't even have... We might have to use Soul Trap. Ugh, I don't want to, but we might. In order to increase our conjure... Or our enchanting at a decent level. Okay, so in here... I remember this site, especially because I made this the thumbnail for the Skyrim's Hidden Treasures episode. It was like that, pretty much. Fill the chalice from the spring. Let's do it. Oh?
It's really too bad. The little accident can happen. Completely unexpected.
Yeah. Lord Harkin's new favorite. Dead so soon after...
Hold on, but you guys can... Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead through your thing. Ooh, let's use Nightingale subterfuge on these guys.
Family.
We're just lucky I was here to return the chalice to Hingalmo so we could make sure Harkon gets it back.
Wait, what? That's not what we agreed. We take it back together.
Idiot. You didn't really think I'd let you walk out of here either.
I want to do that, but I also want to kill these guys.
Well, that's just fine. Orthjalm told me to finish off anyone who got in the way.
Okay, looks like they're going to attack each other regardless. Maybe not, though. Hey, guys, what's up? All right, so you guys attack each other, okay? Meanwhile, I'm going to run over here. No, you guys attack each other. I wonder what happens if we go invisible. They should ideally attack each other, right? Although we can't get back into sneak. Okay, we need to go on the offensive here. I was going to activate Highborn. And then grab Stone Flesh. Why am I always in third person? I keep messing up the button that switches up. Okay, and then we're going to grab Conjure Dremora Lord and put you right there. And then we're going to grab Fast Healing. Heal ourselves up a bit. Okay, and now we can go ahead and grab Bound Bow, jump up here, dual cast that. Okay, also go back down to Unrelenting Force. Down you go. And as Thorn is taking care of whatever her name is, we haven't even talked to these guys. And this guy looks familiar, but it's not the guy that we walked by with Garen Morethi, I don't think. Stalf, I don't remember seeing that name. Nice damage, dude. Have you? I mean, you're not doing too much to me, and I'm just gonna, like, kill you with these arrows. In your head, too. Well... Ideally in your head, it didn't look like that one connected. Okay, nice job, Thorn. All right, fill the chalice with vampire blood. Okay, well, before we do that... Okay, looks like we're done. Okay, where did the other person go? There you are. Kalia? Whatever that name is. Okay. Well, let's give these guys a proper burial, or whatever you want to call it. Burial at sea, but in a sea of blood. You know what I mean? I always do this. This takes a little bit of the time out of the Let's Play, but at the same time, this is what I'd normally do if I was playing this game. So, getting a little insight there, folks. All right. Just twirl her around. I mean, how is this making sense? Imagine if we're holding this person like this and we're just twirling her around. Where did you go? There you are. Land in the middle, please. Down you go. Okay, let's take a look at our quest. Return to Garen Morethi. Yeah, it said fill with the blood of a master vampire. So I thought we were going to have to go back and find Vulcan or whatever his name is. But, oh well, let's go into sneak and enter Redwater Den. Looks like it's going to bring us out to the main location. That was far more anticlimactic than I thought, unfortunately. I thought, like, there'd be an animation of us filling the blood chalice, but no, it was just a press A type of deal. But okay, that's fine. Let's loot these draugrs. Some rich draugrs. You know draugrs, they have to have their gold. I think that's the saying, right? Draugrs always repay their debts, right? Isn't that the saying? Okay. Let's get the hell out of here. We have spent so much time in this location, just because I wanted to look at it from head to toe, and also make sure that we don't miss anything. But We are done. Now, when we exit, there should be two lookouts. Now, unless they could hear all the commotion going on below, why would they be mad at me, right? Why would they aggro on to... Oh! Your vampire blood boils in the sunlight. Okay, we must have a new negative effect now, right? Weakness to sunlight. Health, magic, and stamina do not recover while in sunlight and are reduced by 45 points. Holy shit, that is a big negative. Wow. Okay, hey, you guys cool?
That spell looks dangerous. Keep your distance.
You know what? I think Adrenok would clear out everybody. Yeah, I don't think these people deserve to live. Oh, and they're vampire thralls, too. Come on, Thorn. What are you doing? Any day now. Thank you, Thorn. Okay, and let's get rid of the body as best that we can. In you go. Come on. In you go. Okay, that works. And there should have been one other guy, right? Leaning on the... Does he not care that I killed his... Where'd you go, guy? He was, like, leaning right here. Okay, well, Redwater Den is cleared. Oh, there you are. You cool with that?
Stay away while you got that spell on you.
Nah, I'm not gonna stay away, in fact. Alright, go finish him off. Thorn. Oh, is he not aggroed onto me? And down you go. I mean, if you were a vampire's thrall, you'd want to be killed, right? Let's be honest here. You wouldn't want to live your days as a slave to vampires, especially if they were dead. I wonder what happens. Isn't there a thing where, like, if you kill the master vampire, all the thralls get released or something like that? So we killed the master vampire, down there at least. I'm not sure. You know, it changes. Okay, finally a restoration increase. Jesus. Why does it increase so slowly? All right, return to Garen Morethi. We will do that by traveling back to Castle Volkahar. As a blood-starved vampire, you are hated and feared. Embrace of Shadows added. Your vampire blood boils in the sunlight. Okay, looks like we did get a new effect now. Let's also take a look and see if... Yeah, so now it's a 50% weakness to fire. Negative 50. And, oh god, health, magic, and stamina do not recover while in sunlight and reduced by 60 points. Yeah, this is bad. This is way worse than I thought. And really, the worst thing about it is that our carry weight is going to get decreased by so much. Let's take a look. Oh, actually, 277 out of 335. Nah, that doesn't seem to be too much, actually. Okay, we also got a new power, which is going to be... Embrace the Shadows. Vampire is invisible and has improved night vision for 108, 60, 120. That's 3 minutes. That's 3 minutes of invisibility. Wow. Okay, that might actually just make it better. We're going to take Nightingale Subterfuge. Actually, Nightingale Subterfuge is really good, too. It's like basically a free mayhem spell. Okay. Yeah, that's actually... Okay, that might make up for it, totally. That's 3 minutes of invisibility. So if ever we need a sneak or do anything... I mean, we're already done with the Thieves and the Dark Brotherhood guilds. But still, if we have to... I'm sure there's going to be an instance where we have to sneak past people and it's going to be difficult. Yeah, that's amazing. That's amazing. Okay. Well, we'll see. We'll see if this affects us too much. The weakness to fire sounds like it's going to be really bad, especially because we haven't even dealt with, like, a wizard that has dealt... excuse me. That has dealt a lot of fire damage yet. So I don't know. How's it going, Serana? All right, let's talk to Garen Morethi.
I see you have returned. Lord Harkon will be pleased. You met Stolf and Salonia, I assume? Lord Harkon and I suspected they might follow you there.
I killed them both.
As well you should have. Welcome to the politics of Lord Harkon's court. Vingalmo and Ortheolf both long for our Lord's throne, but cannot make overt moves against him. Each sought to gain power by using his underling to kill you and keep the chalice for himself. By ensuring the chalice reaches our Lord, you have increased his power over them, and at the same time, deprived them of their little pets. You've done Lord Harkon two great services. Take what you've learned to heart, and be careful who you trust. Now, I believe that Lord Harkon wishes to speak with you.
Okay, the Bloodstone Chalice has been removed. Again, totally blind, not sure what other quests await us, although I do know that they're going to tie in with the quest that I did for Dawn Guard. I know that you have to go to the same locations, basically, and do sort of the same stuff, although the place that we just went to, Redwater Den, that was completely different than the one that you do for Dawn Guard. I don't remember if you go to, like, a similar place or a different one, but I definitely did not go to that place, which was obviously very fleshed out, doing the Dawn Guard. So there are, of course, major differences. Anyways...
Ah, you are here. Good.
You wanted to speak to me?
Yes, I did. When I told you that I was grateful for my daughter's safe return, I told the truth. But I did not tell you everything.
I suspected as much.
Good. Strong instincts and a cunning mind will serve you as well as blade, spell, or claw. As you know, vampires are powerful, but we have limits. Our great enemy is the sun. And until recently, it's an enemy we've had no way to fight. For centuries, I searched for an answer to this problem. I found an old prophecy written by a moth priest. Those scholars who read the Elder Scrolls. The prophecy tells of a time in which vampires will gain power over the sun and will no longer fear its tyranny. I believe the secret to unraveling that prophecy is written in Serana's Elder Scroll. I have ordered the court to assemble. I have a new task for us all to carry out, and that includes you. Come now. And hear my proclamation.
As you wish, my lord. For now. Look at all the blood in here! Look at all this blood gone to waste. Look how it perfectly lines up with this texture right here. Game-breaking things that I am saying that I don't need to say to ruin the immersion that we're all feeling right now. But! That's just what I do. Can I... Where's the button to go onto the floor and slurp it all up? Oh well.
Hear my words. The prophesied time is at last upon us. Soon we will claim dominion over the sun itself and forge a new realm of eternal darkness. Now that I have reclaimed one of my Elder Scrolls, I must find a moth priest to read it. I have spread false rumors about the discovery of an Elder Scroll in Skyrim. A moth priest here. Now it is time to see if those efforts have borne fruit. Go forth and search the land for rumors of a moth priest within our borders. Look to the cities. Speak to innkeepers. Carriage drivers, anyone who would meet a traveler. Go now and carry out this task. This is my command.
Excuse me, but I must
address. Any idea how you're going to find a moth priest? Skyrim's a pretty big place.
Do you have any ideas?
Well, back before I... You know. The College of Winterhold was the first place I'd think to go for any kind of magic or historical thing. The wizards know about all kinds of things that people probably shouldn't know about. Actually, now that I think of it, I'm going to come along with you. Surprised I've been really wanting to get out and explore a bit. Lord Vingal.
Too busy plotting to overthrow him to show up.
Wow, and there's no way for me to say no?
I wasn't informed of any such thing.
Okay. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, well, we have our new task in front of us, and we will be exploring that task in the next episode, and I will see you all there. Thank you so much for watching this one. Hope you guys are enjoying the Let's Play so far. Bye-bye.